Hey, everybody. So last night I saw Aladdin, directed by Guy Ritchie, starring Will Smith, Mina Massoud, Naomi Scott, and Marwan Kenzari. This is not nearly as bad as I thought this movie was going to be going into it. It does a lot of the same things as the original, but in different ways, which makes it feel original in some ways. Things that are the same have a little twist to them, and such as the opening is very different. Not wholly different, but it still keeps that same theme of having Genie in a different body or in a different setting to set the story and set everything that's going to go on in the rest of the movie. The opening song is great and sets up the story very well. However, the song Aladdin and Jasmine sing running throughout the city is cut terribly. Multiple times the scene slows down, but the song keeps going at the same pace. It looks as if the lips on the actors have been slowed down and the actors themselves have been slowed down in After Effects. While the lyrics of the song keep going at the regular same pace, you would expect them to. That happens a lot throughout this film. I usually like Guy Ritchie films, but this left me scratching my head multiple times, and it left me questioning why Disney would hire a director who's synonymous with action films and hire him to direct a musical. Has to be countless other directors you could hire that would do a better musical such as this. There's hardly any action scenes in this movie, and what there is could easily be handled by any director. I don't understand why you had to hire Guy Ritchie. He doesn't put a particular spin on this movie. He doesn't put a particular feel on this movie. Everything feels the same as the original. That being said, some of the sets also feel like they're on a set. At times it feels like they're actually in a real world, in a real place. Other times it feels like everything is on a set, and it's really annoying and really bothersome at times. Like I said, the directing, a lot of the shots are pulled in way too close to the actors' faces, and cuts happen at a breakneck speed. It's always cutting from one thing to the next and not letting the audience sit with what they're seeing and really experience and process what's going on screen. It happens so quickly that you're not allowed to see the emotion on the actors' faces to see how they're really feeling. And that happens a lot with Genie, too. A lot of the times I tried to get a grasp on what I was seeing, but it happens so fast you can't tell what the hell is going on. As for the acting, I thought Naomi Scott was great. She has a good performance as doing a live-action Jasmine and really brought that character to life. But Will Smith is by far the saving grace of this film. It's no Robin Williams performance, but he puts his own personal spin on the role to make it feel like his. As for Mina Massoud as Aladdin and Marwan Kenzari as Jafar, they're both terrible. Massoud is a bad actor, and Kenzari is horribly miscast. Multiple times they try to make him seem like this big, daunting, bad guy villain that everybody should be afraid of, but it doesn't come across that way because he just doesn't have that menacing feel to him. His face isn't menacing like Jafar was in the original cartoon. Yes, you can't do a pointy-faced villain in a live-action movie. It's not going to work the same. But you easily could have casted a better actor to really get that point across that you're supposed to be scared and terrified of this guy like these actors are in the movie. Also, they completely changed Iago's character, and it's sorely missed not having Gilbert Gottfried's voice performance having be that great comedic relief that he was in the original movie. I don't understand why you have a magic flying carpet and a monkey that can do anything you want him to and a goddamn genie, but you can't have a talking parrot. That's what crossed the line in this movie. That's where you stop. It's mind-boggling at times. Finally, the CGI is atrocious. Whole New World looks terrible. Abu Araja and the carpet look terrible. And the camera cuts away from them so fast it's hard to gauge what they really look like. It's the same thing with Genie. Will Smith is blue throughout this movie pretty much. There are a lot of scenes where he's a regular Will Smith, not blue and not CGI. But when he is blue in CGI, you don't get enough time with him on screen to really tell if it's looking good at all. And it's worrisome considering that the same company that released this movie just released Avengers Endgame over a month ago with a completely CGI character in Thanos, and that looks great. So I don't understand why that technology couldn't transfer over this movie from Endgame. It's not like Marvel has a certain copyright on the technology that nobody else is allowed to use. It's Disney. Just use the same technology. But overall, I would say that I did like this movie. It's far from good, and it's not the same as the original. If you listen to my latest podcast, you would hear that one of my favorite animated movies was the original Aladdin, mainly because of Robin Williams' performance. And while it doesn't have that, it does have its own spin and own speciality with Will Smith. But I would say that I think this movie is good standing on its own away from the original. If there wasn't an original, I still think I would like this movie. There are a lot of things I did not like about it, but there are also a lot of things I really did like. The Blue Will Smith genie is there throughout the movie, so Disney did not lie to us, which makes me feel good. But in conclusion, I would give Aladdin 2019 a 6.7 out of 10. Like I said, there's a lot of things wrong with this movie, but a lot of things that they do good, and a lot of things I really genuinely enjoyed. There were a lot of times throughout this movie where I had that same feeling watching the original Robin Williams Aladdin that I had watching this. It was a lot of fun at times, but the bad is still there that really drags that point system down. So I really do have to settle with a 6.7 out of 10.